especially I want to thank Noel Norton, the dean of the college. I'm not exaggerating one bit when I say we couldn't have done this without Noel's generosity. I mean that literally. So a long time ago, when we were kids, I want to set the scene for you. I'm not quite sure how we got into this configuration, but Alice was lying on her back on the ground, and I was above her like this, and we were singing. This is what we always did. And do you remember that song, Thank God I'm a Country Boy?
Yeah.
Remember at the end, he goes, woo, thank God I'm a country boy, right? And when I did that, we both went, woo, and the gum fell out of my mouth. And it went right into Alice's mouth. And I wish I could say we were like six, but I think we were like 15. And 30 years later, she won a Tony. So without further ado, she still has the gum in her mouth. She's probably pinching it backstage right now. Please welcome Alice Ripley.
Pajamas. I just came cross country, so please forgive my wrinkles. Wow. Thanks for coming out, everybody. Well, you know, we spent a lot of time today trying to decide how we were going to set up the stage. You know, and we ended up, at one point there was a platform, and I was standing over there, and Corey, this is Corey, by the way, she's going to be so I decided that maybe it was a good idea to bring the music out like this on a stand, because what we're doing here is, this is why we're here, the music. It's not really necessarily anything except the song that was written was somehow considered unacceptable. The songs here, they were banned, B-A-N-N-E-D songs. That's why we're here tonight. So. Thanks to the humanities department, it's really the peace department. And as I was researching this subject and choosing the set list, deciding what to sing, I realized that there's not really a great story. I wish there were a great story. I mean, some of the songs have little tidbits of reasons why they were banned or censored. But there's not really a good reason, which I think is kind of interesting. It's kind of interesting. You know, like they'll say, because of the war. It was because of the Gulf War. But why, though? Why? You know, and at one point, the first one we're going to sing is a Jim Morrison song, The Doors. The Doors had two different songs banned at the same time, one that was thought to incite violence and one that was thought to be an anti-war song. So you gotta wonder, and I think, you know, I'm hoping that there are a lot of students out there tonight that I'm gonna see tomorrow. Are you all out there, some people? Okay. So one of the reasons why I'm here, really the reason I'm here, is for you. But one of the things that I want to do tonight for you is inspire you to start your own fire. And basically what we decided, we discussed it, this subject. We decided that the banned songs, you know, our job is to just write as many bannable songs as we can between now and the end of time. And also plays and characters and inappropriate dialogue. And why not? Because they don't seem to have a really good reason. And the thing is, the they that wants to ban our music, those people, they don't understand. Like, everything was made by an artist. Everything. This room, the things that we're wearing, the music, the piano, the gear, then the tambourine over there in the corner, you know? It was all made by an artist, so it's our job to just blow them away, you know? Instead of trying to explain and get them on our side, let's just blow them away. Because, yeah. want to speak to my students because you people are the next, it's your turn, you know. I mean, at some point, you're going to be the ones who are writing the plays and you're directing and you're going to be the stars on stage and you're going to be the people running the show backstage and, you know, winning the Pulitzer and all that. So get excited, because I am. And when you hear these songs, you'll see how innocuous they seem now. But some of them, probably, like Light My Fire, would probably still be banned in certain parts of the world, because the word fire gets people stirred up. So we're going to go ahead and start and just take our time as we present these songs to you, just so you can hear what they have to say, and you'll probably know almost all of them, probably most of them. So please sing along if you would like to. I'm not kidding, you know. If you want to sing along when we do Like a Prayer and you want to go, oh, 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 you know, we won't get mad. We'll love it. So let's start with this Light My Fire by Jim Morrison, The Doors. He got in trouble because he said, you know, we couldn't get much higher. He wasn't allowed to say higher. And they wanted him to say, can't you say, you know, we couldn't get much better? And he was like, yeah, all right, all right, all right. He goes out and does it live, and of course he sings higher, because of course he's going to sing higher. And then he got in trouble. But it was just for that. It's kind of funny. You know that it would be untrue. You know that I would be a liar if I was to say to you, we couldn't get much higher. So I remember this next song. remember, I was probably living here, it was probably like 25 or something when this song was on the radio. I always liked this song a lot because I love Olivia Newton-John. Who doesn't? Right? Especially this song. Turns out, you know, we've come a long way with our LGBTQ and beyond. And is there another T for they at the end of it now? I hope. I want to be a they. I relate to they, so everybody can call me they instead of she, and that would be great. But anyway, we've come a long way as far as those rights and that awareness. And you know, when this song came out, MTV was new, and videos were new. Nothing had ever been done before like that. And the physical video had two women holding hands. And Olivia Newton-John's character in the video kept trying to come on to them, and they were not interested in her. Which is funny, because I think she's gay, so... I just love that little story, because back in the day, you know, it was very, very risque to have two of the same sex holding hands. And so isn't that kind of awesome? We've come so, it's almost quaint now, in a way. What'd you say?
You know,
I mean, they were just holding hands. Not like anything else was stated about it, but that was too much for them. So anyway, so we're going to do this song. Please sing along. If you want to get up and dance. Blue Lagoon, and they had the orgasm scene. course, Brooke Shields had never had an orgasm before, so she didn't know how to do that. She wasn't a very experienced actress, so they squeezed her big toe. She was going, oh, and that was it. Now that, I know, it's a story, but fact check, I swear to God, it's true. Same kind of thing, like Olivia Newton-John, they put her in an aerobics outfit with like a lover boy headband, and she was all sweaty, so she was just working out. You know, she wasn't doing anything else. I can't, I'm so excited that you're here, by the way. Thanks, Noah. Stand up and take a bow, Noah. Come on. Come on, say, you're a representative for San Diego. Like, come on, say, hello, San Diego, I'm here. There, you showed up with your two moms, and you're one of my favorite families. Two moms and a kid. Well, you have another kid, but she's not here, so forget about it. So anyway, okay, so what's next on the... Oh, all right, well, now we're getting into something a little more serious here. So now this song, actually, you know, well, there's two songs by Billie Holiday. The first one's called Strange Fruit. I don't know, does anybody know that song? Have you heard it? I'll admit that, I mean, I was never serious about not singing the song. But when I chose it, I already knew it. But then I started to learn it. And you spend time with it. You know, it's really hard to sing a song like this. You know, because if you're going to be honest about what it's about, wow. The very first lyrics is Southern Trees. Well, right off the bat, if you're from the South, you know, maybe you're going to sit a little bit differently for the rest of the time. You know, you might get up and leave, I don't know. It's definitely, it's something, so I mean, I guess my reaction to it was the reason to do it, right? Yeah. So let's go ahead and do that one, Strange Fruit.
Oh!
Subscribe to Google Play. It's one of my favorite things to subscribe to, a really good music service, because every time I listen to Strange Fruit, somebody makes a penny, a couple of pennies. The only version, that version has a real long introduction. The only version I've heard is a live version of the song that was recorded. You know, somebody in the back of the club just pressed play and record at the same time, probably, right before she started singing. That song kind of, it's hard to describe, but I think that you can make up your own melody, and it works. So everybody should try it. Try singing that song, it's not easy to do. And then there's another song that she sang called Love for Sale. It's a standard Cole Porter song, but it was banned because it's about a prostitute. It's a little too much for us pilgrims, I guess. It's a profession in the business, and it has this really pretty, this kind of, I don't know, like an old-fashioned, they call it a verse, you know, before the song starts, so we'll do that part, too.
Let the poet's pipe of love
these mini waters. I love the little mini ones. You don't have to commit to a big giant. So, and they have even smaller ones. Actually, my favorites. So let's see. In the Air. Okay, so this song was in a show, a Broadway show. That my last Broadway show contains this song, this Phil Collins song, because American Psycho. Well, the story takes place in the 80s, and by the way, I think, isn't there an American Psycho in the White House? Is that one of the...
Yeah.
He does the poker face. Donald Trump Jr. does the... Looks just like Patrick Bateman. Back me up on this one. It's a sidebar. I have nothing against 44.5, I'm just saying. That was sidebar. Just a sidebar. It hasn't lived up to the true potential yet, that's why. That other half a point will get in there later, maybe. So. But anyway, American Psycho, I digress a lot, have you noticed? That's the reason you're here, isn't it? Come on, you guys. So now I can't remember what I was going to say.
In the Night, in a Broadway show.
Oh yeah, so American Psycho was the last Broadway show I did, and the audition, I love the story, I won't tell it right now, maybe some other day, but I had this really great audition for that show, and they wanted me to sing two pop songs, so I picked two Human League songs. Fascination, keep feeling fascination, and then Don't You Want Me. I was working as a waitress in a cocktail bar, right? You want to sing, don't you? Come on. You didn't think you were going to do, because the light's not on you. You thought I couldn't see you. So I decided, they only wanted to hear one song, because they were like, well, everything, we don't really need to hear anything else. And I said, well, I want to sing this one. So I sang, I chose to sing Don't You Want Me. It's just a little sidebar. Don't You Want Me is in the show, but I didn't know it. So that's pretty cool, isn't it? Isn't that cool? Out of all the songs I can do. So anyway, this song's in the show too, and so it's really a Broadway. This is like musical theater right here. In the Air Tonight. And this song was banned because of the Gulf War. I'm sure it's like everything was because of the Gulf War or 9/11. Because there was something about this was gonna make people it was gonna incite violence or something. Jeez, he's just a drummer, you guys. And Phil Collins is just a drummer. It's not that big a deal. Okay, so I was going to take a sip. Maybe I actually can take a sip of water.
Yeah. Start
ready. Got some friends here tonight. My good friend Jim's up there in the corner trying to hide. Let's give him a hand, guys. Representing Oceanside or Paloma, right? I lived here for a while in San Diego, in your fine city, and as a matter of fact, I never knew that this campus was here. And back me up, right?
It's my first time here today.
Yeah. Also, my friend Kathy, you know, she lived here for a while, she didn't know. So you guys do a really good job of hiding up here. It's beautiful. Wow, who knows? I want to go to school here. Don't you? You're looking that good.
School. I did enough school, but I'd love to work here, Scott.
Okay. All right, so anyway, here's some Broadway musical for you. Here's a Broadway musical.
So
woman for all my life. Oh Lord, and can you feel it coming in the air tonight? Oh Lord, can you feel it coming in the air tonight? Oh Lord. Oh, this is my favorite one. So Madonna, she's like, I'm not trying to be provocative, like this. You know, when Madonna first happened, when she was first a thing, all of us were just in awe of her, whether we admitted it or not. And, you know, for you youngsters who wonder, was there ever a time when it was unacceptable to see your bra through your shirt? Was there ever a time when it was unacceptable to show bra straps or, like, show your underwear at all? Yes, it was totally unacceptable. I graduated from high school in 1981. Yes, I know. Everybody can go, what? I asked my parents for a jean jacket for Christmas, and they thought that was too radical. They thought that I was on the wrong side of the tracks for wearing a jean jacket. They really didn't give it to me. If I listened to AC/DC, they would have thought there was, like, what's wrong with Alice? So see how far we've come. So, like a prayer, though, Madonna likes to say things like, you know, I'm not trying to be provocative, but how I feel about it is, you know, you can't own the word prayer. I'm sorry. You can't tell me how to pray or that I can't say the word prayer, and that's really what this is. But the video, because the Vatican went crazy. Vatican went crazy about like a prayer, and you're going, come on, at least she's talking about praying and something beautiful. Just because it's not by your book, come on, you know. I mean, really. But then again, you know, the video. So it was a video. It wasn't just a song, and she, you know, she's in a slip making love to Jesus, who's this beautiful black man who comes off a cross, you know what I mean? It's kind of like, geez, Madonna. Everything's on fire, you know. And this is the most radical thing of all. Do you guys remember? She went back to her natural color. She was always double platinum. She went back to her natural, this is as radical as making love to a black Jesus. She went back to her natural hair color and her waves. Remember that? You're too young. Anyway, yeah, so there you go, people. And now that I ruined it, now it's not going to be any good because I talked too much about it. So please sing along, because this is, you got to sing along with this, right? Just like, shake the ground of USD and cause a little bit of controversy because you're singing that. Tell them I told you. Okay. I think I remember the ending. All right. That's all she's going
to
give me.
We'll wing it. Here, I'll give it to you again.
Life is a mystery.
Thank you.
think that's an absolutely beautiful lyric. It's beautiful. And so much fun to sing along with.
But I learned that, like,
Madonna is just banned in Egypt, just from now until the end of time. But I hope someday I get to meet her and shake her hand and say thank you. Because when Madonna first became Madonna, those of us who, I don't know, I had a little bit of an attitude about it. But then the thing is, like, the decades went on, and she's still, do you know what I mean? Like, that's the thing. Like, now she's the queen to me. She's fierce because she, like, is Taylor Swift still going to be doing stuff in 20 years, I wonder? I mean, if she is, then I'll really respect Taylor Swift. Kidding. It's like, it's kind of like, I want to go, really, seriously, you're singing about heartbreak? Come on. Come on, you're Taylor Swift. It's not like you don't have heartbreak, but you're Taylor Swift. And you're a teenager, but okay. I don't want to get down on people under 30. How's my lipstick? I think I just messed it up. Is it okay? Okay, so here's my favorite band, Beatles. I just had this idea that every other band that came after them really, like, just kind of copies the Beatles. That's my own idea. But anyway, this song was banned, obviously, because people thought it was about drugs. Oh my goodness. Drugs. Don't want to sing about drugs or, like, you know, anything. It's funny because, okay, in a couple of minutes I'm going to sing I Can't Get No Satisfaction. And that song was censored. But then 40 years later, they sang the song at the Super Bowl, and they were the only band that wasn't censored. Isn't that interesting? It's kind of, I don't know if it's good or bad that the stuff that's on the radio right now is so much more brutal than Lucy in the Sky with Diamonds, but it's not as well written. So let's all go out and write great songs. We get in trouble. Okay. It'll be like John Lennon. He's got two songs on this list, and this is one of them. Picture yourself in a boat on a river with tangerine trees and marmalade skies. Somebody calls you, you answer quite slowly. A girl with kaleidoscope eyes. Turnstile. to stand as my friend, but I won't use it. I'll just go like this. Okay, yeah, so I told you the story about the Jagger Richards song, I Can't Get No Satisfaction. It was, you know, when they sing, trying to get some girl. That was it. That was the big, like, oh no. Trying to get some girl? Really? Come on. With all that music that's out on the radio today.
It wasn't like that back then.
So anyway, this one, oh man, this is a good one. Because you get to like kind of stick it to the man here just a little bit. Lyrics, yeah. What are we supposed to do? wow, I think I just found a new staple. We got to do that song a lot.
That was awesome.
Somehow it's more equipment than ever, right? Just like hitting the top of that staff, just kind of like screaming it. Which happens to be my thing. Okay, well, if you didn't already know, this is really fun. Thanks, everybody. Thanks, everybody, for coming out. Thank you, Corey, for... I mean, we're not ending or anything. I just feel like saying thank you. It's just a time. Kevin and Scott, making it sound and look beautiful. And my brother, Scott. And the reason why he had me pinned down, he was torturing me. That's why he was on top of me like that. Singing Thank God I'm a Country Boy. And we didn't miss a beat. Woo! Are you an alien? I just went... For a split second. And we got it back together. It was green, fresh enough. I know, you all thought of that, what we used to call it, right? I'm not going to even say that because it's disgusting. I'm not going to say what you think I'm going to say. What we used to call freshen up. I'm not going to say it, you guys. You can talk about it later. No, I hate that word. Okay. Now you want to know what it is, right? You're going to go Google. Freshen up. What did they used to call freshen up back in the old days? What the hell is freshen up? Okay. So this next song, Carole King is a genius. Carole King is a gift to mankind. Carole King is a gift to the universe. And all you have to do is go see the show Beautiful and sit in the audience. And even if you're a Carole King fan like I am, and you know every word, you're sitting there going, are you kidding me? Like the songs, the hits just keep on coming, Jim. The hits just keep coming. So this is in that show, pretty sure, right?
Yeah.
This is Beautiful. And originally this song, Will You Still Love Me Tomorrow, was written, Carole King, you know, the Beatles recorded one of her songs. Before she was Carole King, you know, that we know, who sang You've Got a Friend, all that, Tapestry. The Beatles recorded Chains. And the Shirelles recorded this. And so their song is ba 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 ba. Tonight you're mine completely. Boom boom ba boom boom. You do your love. I mean, it's almost too fast when you hear it. So that's all well and good, and I usually would always want to go back to the original. But Carole's version is just, I can't resist it, so we're gonna do that version. Tonight you're mine completely. You give your love so sweetly. Tonight. did. I don't ever want to see you again. Just kidding. I love boom stands. Well, that's pretty much a perfect song. I love that song. Yes, and here's another one. Here's another one that has several versions that are out there. Brian Wilson is, I don't know where the world would be without his contribution. Really, really grateful for Brian Wilson and the Beach Boys, everything that they did. I remember when I was in junior high, I was in this dance number that was a thing that we did. And I think it must have been physical education, like PE class, but it was California Girls. We had this choreography. Well, East Coast girls are hip. And I would consider myself an East Coast girl because I was growing up in Ohio, but even though I was born in California. So the California girls, like, I felt like one of them, but I was really just a Northern girl or an East Coast girl. But I was born in California, and I love it out here. I just wish it wasn't so far away from the East Coast. So, oh man, love Brian Wilson. This is one of my favorite songs. And of course, David Bowie recorded it. I think that was on the Let's Dance album, right? The last track on the second side thing. You know, if you back in the days when we had LPs, if you did know the songs on the second side, you really liked that record. Because you had to turn it over. So this song, God Only Knows, was banned because of the word God. Because maybe people thought we were saying, you know, taking the Lord's name in vain. But maybe it's really, no, God actually knows. You know, it's not in vain. You're saying, no, God knows. I understand, you know, you don't want to take the Lord's name in vain, but come on, it's such a great song. You can't censor this one. You gotta give Brian Wilson the benefit of the doubt. Love you. You never need. to be really embarrassed, but I don't know, you must have been about 2 years old. And you came over to my place where I lived in Poway. Anybody know where Poway is? And we just forced this on you, like, Candace, sing! Sing for us, Candace! Sing for us, Candace! Sing for us, Candace! Sing! And you were holding the little microphone. Remember, Cal? And we put on, that was when pocket songs came out. Maybe you'd go to the mall and you'd go into a booth and record a song on a track. Now they don't exist anymore because everybody has it on their phone. But so I had a little module in my living room and I would just get these pocket songs. And we had The Little Mermaid because I went to see The Little Mermaid with Candace. And because of that, I decided it was my favorite Disney movie and nothing has ever eclipsed it. I don't care about Beauty and the Beast. I don't care about anything else. It's all about The Little Mermaid. So, you know, we put on The Little Mermaid and Candace, back then everybody videoed everything, like 8mm video, the big cameras. And we have a video of Candace going, part of your world. All the way to the end. So thanks for being here, honey. I'm so excited that you're here. Love you. I love you so much, it's ridiculous. I try to be a controlled aunt. I try to control myself. And not go too crazy when I see them, but no, might go crazy later. So this song was out back then when we were hanging out at the officers' club at Miramar at the base, or like going to the mall and dancing at the Mexican place, drinking margaritas. That's all we did in the 80s. It was before we had problems in the world. Just dance to songs like this. So this song was probably censored because it's really not very polite to call people names, you know, or to like a generalization, like walk like an Egyptian. I mean, I can understand why they got it, because those paintings, you know, there's flat on the wall, it was, and it, you know, that's where they came from. So give the Bangles a break too. I mean, they're the Bangles. Nobody even knows who they are anymore. So just give them a break, and we'll enjoy the song. A lot of words. If you know the words, please sing along. All the paintings on the old tombs, they do the sand dance, don't you know? If they move too quick, they're falling down like a domino. All the bizarre men by the now, they got the money on a bet. Gold crocodiles, they snap the teeth on your cigarette. Foreign types with the hookah pipes, the floor, they got the moors. You drop your drink, then they bring you more. All the school kids so sick of books, they like the punk and the metal band. When the buzzer rings, they're walking like an Egyptian. All the kids in the marketplace say,
all the cops in the donut shop say, hey.
like an Egyptian. Sax solo of the song. How come I can't find that U2 song that we were working on? It's not in here. Oh, we didn't do Imagine either, did we?
We did. You skipped it.
I know, why?
I was going with your flow.
What happened to this? This, like, did I get the wrong book? Because, hold on a minute, because we've got to sing Imagine. Right? Yeah. We've got to sing Imagine. Okay, let's make that, let's do that one. I don't know why things got out of order. Oh, geez, I'm just a girl. I can't figure things out. Well, okay, so we're going to finish up. Let's finish with Imagine.
Okay.
And then we're going to take a short little break. And then I'm going to come out and do some surprises for you all if you want to come back. I gleaned a guitar from Corey's husband, so I'll play some of my songs on guitar and sing them, and I'll also do my monologue I'm working on. It's because I want you students to see, I want you guys to see, like, you really need to come up with your own thing, and be ready for somebody to say, will you come do the show with us? You gotta come up with your own, come up with your own Hamilton, or come up with your own, you know, Next to Normal. Whatever, because we need you to write the next Rent. We need you to do it. It took Lin-Manuel 10 years, so the thing is, Meisner said you don't have to do it now. He said it takes 20 years. So instead of seeing that as a, great, albatross, look at it as like a gift. Like, I don't have to know anything right now. Like, I can just study. So I've been studying Virginia Woolf, the play, Edward Albee's play, for decades, and, you know, when I'm ready, when the world's ready to have me play Martha, I'll be ready, I'll know it.
Yes.
So, you know, because it's that play is three acts, and it's, I still don't know what it's about. So what I started to do is, this is what I'm going to do after we sing our last song here. I'm going to take a break, and we can go use the ladies' room. The men can use the men's room. The ladies can use the ladies' room. That's how it usually goes, yes. Take a break, then you'll come back. And then I'll do some of this Virginia Woolf, because what I started to do is, I was doing it as a vocal exercise, and reading it out loud, and it kind of came up off the page and started flying on its own. And so I've decided I'm going to memorize the entire play, which is going to take me 50 years. It's three acts, and I'm going to do all four characters like I am my own wife. And I've already got 21 pages memorized. It's about a minute a page. But I'll just do, like, you know, I'll do 5 or 6 minutes for you. Because if you don't mind, I would really like to, it's new. I've only done it for an audience once, this. And I want to hear the response, if there is one. I want to hear what you think about it. Maybe you could give me feedback on it, too. Because it's real challenge. It's really fun. So when we come back, we'll do that. And I'll sing you some of my songs, because I like to play some of my music so you can get to know me, you know, through the songs that I write too. So I'll do a couple of those. But let's just sing Imagine. Imagine was banned after 9/11. It's like the time when we need it the most. It's fascinating, don't you think? And the reason was that I read anyway was because the first line says, imagine there's no heaven. And people didn't like that. I don't know. I mean, you're just imagining it. I'm not saying there is no heaven. Just saying imagine it. I mean, just, you know, so that's kind of interesting, isn't it? It's too ironic, I think, when we needed the song the most when people decided we didn't want to hear it anymore. But I'm singing it tonight. So thanks to the humanities, the peace department is what I call you, because I love that word, peace. Thank you for bringing me here, and thank you for suggesting this, because the humanities, they're studying this right now, this semester. And so thanks for bringing me in on your project, and it was really interesting to get to know, you know, what songs were on that list. They're all some of my favorite songs, right? So much fun to sing. So I guess my conclusion here is rock and roll is not a genre, it's not a type of music, it's a lifestyle. It's a way of living. It's a way of seeing the world. So I suggest that all of us do that, that we all rock it a little bit. We rock out a little bit, because the people that want to ban the music, what they don't realize is that they need us. So like I said earlier, you know, all we have to do is just really be amazing and blow them away. And while they're looking at this, we can go over here and do whatever we want. So we've got them suspended over here. They're bamboozled. I'm just kidding. We're all the same. You know, there's really no separation between us and them. We're all the same, and we really are a community. And sometimes we're on stage, and sometimes we're in the audience. So someday I'll be in your audience, probably. And thanks for being here tonight.
band set up a lovely reception that was supposed to be for after the concert, but why not? Get it going now. So enjoy an adult beverage and a snack if you want. And then I told Alice, hey, if you come sing a set of band songs, you can do whatever you want for the second set. And let me tell you something. You have to be very, very careful when you give Alice Ripley carte blanche. So there's no telling what's going to happen afterwards, but please come back. Thanks, everyone.